overpowered strikers, FIFA 22. Let's get it. Beautiful people, what's happening? My name is Mike LaBelle. Welcome back to the YouTube channel. As always, if you choose to ring that bell, to subscribe with us, it's high key appreciated. I got 15 strikers, overpowered. That's right, energy uplifted. Criteria, pretty simple. Must be a striker or a center forward, default position. We're looking at overperformers. That's what overpowered is all about. Max 83 overall, and then no repeat selections. Comment down below. Do you agree? Do you disagree? 15 names, quick fire, coming in with that fuego. Bakambu, wild card selection. Some of you will stand by, others will look the other direction. I understand. Statistically speaking, when you bring up the card value, that allocation looks promising. However, it's gonna vary a little bit. He's inconsistently talented, and I feel that he deserves a mention, so we've done that. If you want me to talk about wingers and midfielders, please like this video. Should have mentioned that early on. Morales, one upgrade away from something special, something spicy, a little hot tamale. I might just be hungry. Just needs a touch to the pace or the passing to truly prosper. And we have seen upgrades in the past. This is his first form in FIFA. I'm talking DBZ reference. Dragon Ball Z for the kiddos that don't know. You should know. Classic. Jonathan David, 78 overall. We put him into motion to go with the 84. Major upgrade. Some people on social are saying, I hear the Canadian national anthem when this man comes out. They're calling him the Canadian R9. I'm not sure if I'm ready to get that far into the cosign, but I approve completely. Halloween is around the corner. This is when your neighbor leaves the chocolate outside. There's no supervision. You can take everything, and they're full size, not the mini bars. I don't know if that's only an American reference. And when I give you the metaphors and the wordplay and the puns, if you're on board, I expect a comment acknowledging what we're discussing, what we're talking about, because it's something that makes our channel unique. We take pride in that. Iñaki Williams oozes out overpowered nature. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, the secret of the ooze. Another example or reference point I hope someone is able to connect to or relate or remember. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles and Power Rangers, some of the best material growing up. Right up there with Legos and Lincoln Logs. Isak, simply put, strange player, sort of unusual. I'm not gonna go as far as Stranger Things. And you have untapped or unlocked potential. And I know he's got the 86. We already put that into motion on the channel. I'm still need some more upgrades. This is like when you have a growth spurt late in life, but you kept all those skills that you had already developed when you were normal size or even undersized. Often happens in basketball. Isak moves and grooves like a player that would be much shorter. Maybe not as wide-bodied in stature. And he's equal-footed. Nice touch. Mbolo! Sleeper pick. I'm not hitting the sheets early. And if you're a FIFA historian or an enthusiast, if you remember the Abarbo days, Mbolo was right there. Ultimate team terrification. I just made up a new word for a player in October that you're terrified to go up against. Also has 89 strength and he can catch a through ball. This is a wide receiver. João Felix. What's missing this year? I rate him, but based on the criteria, he should be higher. But something's just not connecting. We're missing a character in the Wi-Fi password. He's still got a competitive package, but this is almost as if you had a high-rated Pokemon card, but it wasn't the holographic. It wasn't shiny. It wasn't as rare. And the deliverables match up. Talisca! This is gonna be another year that he is special. Extraordinary. Already with the 84 in form, or the one to watch if you completed that SBC. I recommend both. But even his default, this 82, honorary member of the club, not going anywhere. Mkhitaryan, gonna surprise you. Early birthday present. Unexpected trip. Free drinks at the bar. Your girlfriend shows up because she thinks you're up to no good. That last one might not be a positive surprise, but we do a lot of this off the cusp, and it's in the video. But his shooting, his passing, his dribbling, I like his body type, 88 stamina as well, so he's not going to die out. He has enough pace. I'm waiting for the upgrade. Once we get an 85 or an 86, this man is going to be phenomenal. There's no denying that. And right now, he's just being overlooked. I don't co-sign putting my man Mkhitaryan over there by the bathroom in the restaurant. That's not cool. Martial, truly dislike going up against him. He catches through balls like very few players. Kind of relentless, in your face, always feels as if an explosive sprint is coming for you. Just a menace on those counterattacks, or even the super sub duties. All of the above, I dislike. And even though my personal performance is never as good as my opponent's with Martial, I have to acknowledge and recognize what he does, how he does the things that he does, at least virtually. Gabby, Jesus, Brazilian Jesus, agile, simply put, agile, side to side, lateral movement. For this rating restriction or this category in general, it's pretty unmatched. It's unparalleled. Even if you started to get to the extremely expensive or high rated players, they're move and groove, their wiggle work, their left stick dribbling. Hard to argue it's going to be much better than Jesus. And he can convert well in the box. He just got some of the quickest feet in FIFA 22. I did not say that he is the fastest sprint speed or the strongest or even the most gifted with finishing or finesse shots, but his dribbling and touches and general offensive movement is impressive. No denying. Malin. Yeah, this is high on the list. I know, but this is the definition of overpowered. Used him to kickstart the year. He never let me down. More reliable than super glue, and I wish that I had an additional portion of this analogy because I feel that it needs a second part just to boost that credibility. He's insured. You could pick the bank. Danielle can always be in my team, off the bench, practice squad, some sort of role player. I've only got positive superlatives to attach to Malin. I know we can sit here and nitpick, but he is fast enough. He fits the game well enough. Meta Malin should be the rebrand as to what he's able to give you. And of course, as with the majority of this list, they cost nothing. Every one of you watching can afford every single player that we have put together from start to finish. Angel Correa. Maybe he's an angel. Maybe I shouldn't reference that. I'm not sure, but he's one of my favorite attacking players in La Liga. Hands down, kind of a better version of Jesus. So if you like Gabby, then you're gonna love Correa. Just gifted with the footwork, is able to intercept and read the game and be deceptive and score big goals, has that clutch factor. He's impactful, he's dynamic. I feel as if I'm getting a competitive advantage. When we're getting to the front three, all of them could really make my video where I discussed meta players without regard to rating or cost. They would be in that argument. They could be in the comments section. They could make a case on their behalf if they wanted to go full on detective. Teixeira, welcome back to FIFA. Started off a little bit lackluster. Now that he has his upgrade, 82 overall, really rerunning the years, reintroducing himself. We're not talking about Jay-Z. We're not on a comeback tour, but what's right is right. What matches and makes sense. I'm not sure where I was going there. But I do support, and I do not underestimate, nor should you brush Teixeira under the radar or discredit what he's accomplished in the past and in this new foot item. It's just upgraded in the right areas and stat lines. We're talking about players that truly surprise you and overperform virtually. Guys you wanna pick up, especially if you don't have the big budget. You're gonna fill in the squad. And it's easier said than done when we're dealing with strikers. This is a position that typically gets more expensive relatively quickly. And at number one, and if you've used Muriel, he fits the game so well. He might be the epitome of an underrated player or an overpowered player. He's had this role, assignment, recognized position for the last 10 years of FIFA. I'm not exaggerating. If you've been playing Ultimate Team or even head-to-head, when has Muriel not been good or not been a player that's on your list or that you don't pay attention to? He's not on the scouting report. And even on the actual pitch, all he does is score goals. Limited minutes, does not matter. Off the bench, he's still got active feet. He's ready to be that X factor goal scoring machine. Just has a certain art and confidence and presence to be able to find the back of the net. I wish that I shared even the smallest form of comparison with his execution and percentage play for converting opportunities. That's my list. Let me know in the comments. Do you agree? Do you disagree? If you want that wingers or the midfielders video, I'm talking ASAP, make sure to drop a like. It is free to subscribe and stay connected with me on social. I'll have a lot more content coming out on the daily grind.